I was bad for 2 days. After, I'll tell you, they say side effects. Side effects? It wasn't even Woodpecker Gold, man. It was terrible. And I tell you what, I know what you're thinking. Yes, it was worse than having a baby.
Yeah, I've just seen the strong man outside. The strong man, yes. He's been using steroids to build up his arms and legs. Anabolic? No, just his arms and legs.
And then I realized that for the past year, it's been easier to get heroin than a haircut, which is why I look like this, and which is why I have long sleeves on.
But me and my Jew dad, we have so much in common. DNA. And what else? He's a writer. And I can read.
So, again, with coronavirus, there was a report saying the government are going to trial actually infecting coronavirus in young people to see how it affects them and how they can monitor it. And I thought to myself, I thought they did that last year when they opened up the schools.
Whoa. What are you? I'm the greatest entertainer, aren't I? And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, tonight, we are going to entertain you with a little bit of magic. See, what we're going to do, is we're going to have a look at the greats of magic. Think of the greats of magic. Houdini, who's Dini? No. Houdini, that's what I asked you. Houdini, are you going to do that again? What? Pretending not to understand words that I say. I have no idea what you mean. That is not big and it's not clever.
Me. Hey, thanks so much for joining us here tonight in the Henn Houch. Ouch. That's it. I see we've got a couple of our comedians here already. Hello, Viney. Hello, K-Mac. My goodness gracious me. We have a show full of human beings that only have one name. I know. We've got Viney, we've got Wade, we've got Kenny, we've got K-Mac, we've got Sing, and we've got Henn. To be fair, we haven't got Sing. Singer's song off. After coming and standing in at the last minute last week, he's asked for a week off. A week off, a night off. Last week he asked for the night off. So maybe because it's Easter. Roses are red, violets are blue. I'm not doing jokes about Jesus Christ 2. The film, Jesus Christ 2. I miss the cinema. I want to go back to the cinema. I do think it's getting better. I say cinema. Movies. I think we can start to see the wood for the trees before we've been seeing the trees for the trees for the trees. Barking up quite a few of the wrong ones. But we can see the wood for the trees. Is that right? Ah, and I would give my left arm, which I did, to go to the cinema and see a film and sit with people whose mobile phone explodes with light during the really nice, scary bits. or people who pick up their phone and talk on their phone. People who eat food loudly. I would put up with that. I'd be putting up with farting and coughing. Not so much the coughing. But I would be putting up with all that just to go to the movies. Oh, but that it's around the corner. It is. What else has been going on this week? Oh, yeah, the clocks went back this week, didn't they? I know what you're thinking. No, the clocks did go back this week. They went back to 1975. They went forward on the weekend. Yeah, yeah. I'm always happy for springing forward. Hi, Kenny. Always happy for springing forward. But, yeah, Wednesday the clocks went back because the government report, I nearly said independent report, the government report that there was no constitutional racism in this country. I didn't write it. Thing is, right, it's what they say. I can't, what can you do? You could ask your friends. You could ask your friends if they think that's true. So, yeah, do that. Ask your friends to see if they think that's true. And then if you can't ask your friends like that, then you haven't got the right friends, have you? I don't know. What else is going on? Oh, blimey. This is very controversial today, isn't it? Vaccine passports. Oh, if you're an anti-vaxxer, a mask denier, do you know what I mean? Those sort of people, COVID idiots, right? I'm not talking to you. I am. Listen, stay. That's fine. But this has nothing to do with you, right? COVID passports got nothing to do with you. Go away. Nothing to do with you. COVID passports, really, it's another smokescreen. It's another smokescreen. Do you know how many people have been vaccinated in this country? Do you know? You, in the corner, do you know how many people? As of 5 o'clock tonight, 4.9 million people have actually been vaccinated. It takes two to tango, people. Two jabs. 4.9 million. That is 10 million short of what Bodger said he would promise in December. He promised 14 million jabs by, 14 million vaccines by 15th of February this year. Then he changed his mind. That's fine. More jabs in arms is a good thing. It's a good thing. The more you get, the better it is. But that still leaves 28 million people to be vaccinated in the next 12 weeks, which is good. That'll be in the next 12 weeks, 3 months, we will have 33 million people vaccinated. That's half the population, roughly, which is great. But you can't have a vaccine passport with that, can you? Even if you're going away on an aeroplane, there's no need for a vaccine passport. Because if you go away on an aeroplane and you've been vaccinated, when you come back, if there's a pandemic, you should be quarantining in a hotel for 10 days. That's what the big countries do. My brother is in Australia and he was going to go to New Zealand this year to see his family, my family as well. So he booked a plane to New Zealand in January to go in February. Have I lost you yet, right? So he booked his plane in January to go to New Zealand in February. He rang his niece, who happens to be my niece as well, rang his niece and she said, have you booked your quarantine hotel? He said, no. She said, you need to book your quarantine hotel. So he booked his quarantine hotel, hoping he could get it in February. The earliest date he could get was May the 15th. So he paid for a flight to New Zealand, but he couldn't go on it. That's how you do it. When we've got a pandemic, you just don't just make up the rules as you go along. Bah, 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 bah. So there's no need for one if you're going away. And you should be going away unless you're working or it's a family emergency, really. Pubs. Come on. Vaccine passports for pubs. Come on. The people that are getting vaccinated, over 50s, vulnerable, and a few people with asthma, right? That's the people. That's the criteria. Over 50s, mainly. Most big pubs in big cities don't want the over 50s nursing a pint for an hour. It's not going to happen. Also, some families, right, some partners may have younger partners. Like for me, it would be, I'm going at the pub now, you're coming. What do you mean you can't come? Oh, you don't get vaccinated till September. I'll see you later. Mind you, that's not a bad idea, is it really? So it's never going to work. I like going to the pub with my children. You can't do that. If if people under 40 haven't been vaccinated. It's not going to happen. It's just a smokescreen to divide us. By four, take away two, put the first number you thought of. So we've got no Av tonight, but my goodness gracious me, we have got some great comedians. I am waiting on somebody from California who's convinced that the show starts in another 8 hours. Whether or not they turn up, who knows? Hey, yeah, there's no Av. Av said to me he didn't want to do the show because he wanted a night off because he's going to be very tired this week. Very tired. So we're going to start the show. We're going to go to see K-Mac. Yep, okay, good. He was elsewhere. We're going over to Los Angeles. K-Mac is now a friend of the show because he was with us last year and he was outside in his garden. Is he still outside in his garden? K-Mac.
No, I'm not outside this time. I've been allowed to come back inside to the house. You know, my wife said, okay, you can come inside now. So I spent my time on exile out there. So now I'm inside. So thank you all very much. Thanks, Steve, for having me on the show again. I appreciate it.
It's
noon here in L.A.
You know, sorry, it's what?
It's noon, yeah. It's
noon.
Yeah. You guys do say that, right? You say noon?
We say noon, but we don't say it often.
Well, it's afternoon?
We lie. We say, good afternoon. Even when it's raining, good afternoon.
Yeah, you got a real polite over there. I have to go. I've never been there, man. I've never been in the UK. I don't know if I want to go, man. I mean, you know, you have Prince Harry and Meghan.
Oh, no, no, no. We don't have them. You have them.
Yeah, well, we have them now. But they said the reason I was watching the interview and they said one of the reasons they left the UK was for racism. I said, you leave the UK because of racism and you come to the United States? I mean, how bad could it have been there? I mean, really?
Oh, you have no idea.
Black people in as pets or something over there? I mean, what's going on? You know, come over here, this is like coming to the belly of the beast, you know, as far as racism is concerned. That's crazy.
I get what you're saying. But I've been watching a lot of box sets during lockdown, and I've been watching the like NYPD Blue from the 80s.
Yes.
And the casting for American shows way back then is brilliant compared to what we do here.
Really?
Yeah.
What's the difference? I don't get it. What's the difference?
The difference is, in England, all the actors in the 80s were predominantly white. That's...
Oh, okay. So even the bad guys were white.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Don't get me started on it. Ain't half hot, Mum.
Okay, I get it. I get it now. I understand.
So it's that. It's sort of behind the scenes, man. It's not good.
Well, it kept, you know, those shows kept a lot of black people employed, but you know, well, maybe not in the roles that they would have liked, you know, but you had a lot of Shakespearean actors playing like pimps and prostitutes and gangbangers. And then they go on Othello on Broadway, right? But they play the junkie, Jimmy the Drug Pusher on NYPD Blue.
with tights on.
Yeah, oh, man.
Hey, but you know, it's like everywhere, really. It's not, you know, not everyone's an idiot.
No, just most places, it seems like.
Yeah, go on then.
But I can't say, man. I'm pretty, you know, I've been landlocked. I've been to Hawaii, but that's the furthest I've been from the United States.
I'm a bit ignorant on a lot of things, right? But is Hawaii one of the states in America?
Yes.
Oh, that's all right then.
I forgot. I guess I'm a little bit ignorant. Right. Well, let's just say, to me, it's like another country. You know?
Yeah.
Oh. It's over the water. It's like a 6-hour flight, you know what I mean? It's like, come on, man.
Right. I get it. You should come to Redditch if you want another country. Right. I'm gonna stop talking because I still believe children are our future, and that we will get Wade back. He still thinks he's on in 8 hours. So, are you ready to do? Are you ready to do your stuff, K-Mac?
Yeah. I am definitely.
Excellent. I'm so glad you're back, ladies and gentlemen. Big hand back in the hen house. It's K-Mac.
All right. Thank you, guys. I used up some of my funny talking with Steve here. I thought that was part of the act. But anyway, thank you guys for having me. Yeah, man, over here in the U.S., I mean, it's beautiful weather today here in L.A. Perfect weather. I think it's like 82 degrees. Sunshine is out. It's clear. No fires like it was the last time. When I was on the show the last time, we were having all these fires. Everything was on fire. I believe we're in the middle. I think that's when the pandemic just started. You know, somewhere around March, April, it was when I was last on the show. But yeah, you know, during that pandemic, man, you know, you locked down. You know, I was locked down for months. It's like 90 plus days without being able to get out at all. You know, and when you're home by yourself, you know, you start thinking weird thoughts and developing weird things, you know, weird habits. So not necessarily weird, but sometimes different. So one of the things I did, and I decided I was going to shave all the hair off my body. Everything. Clean as the board of hell. Come on, get on out of here, man. I was talking to my son. He's walking through. Yeah, I told you I've got loud back in the house this time. But yeah, clean as the board of health. Clean as the board of health. And I look strange. I did. I look just like a baby. Clean as a baby. With a really big penis. So I kind of look like what you would call a big dick baby. But, you know, it wasn't so bad. My wife kind of liked it, you know, so we kind of play this game now called Big Dick Baby. And I've been keeping it like that ever since, so. Yeah, man, it's a pandemic. You learn to do new things, you know. Another thing is, one thing is I've been eating kind of bad, you know. I gained weight during the pandemic. I'm sure some of you all did, too. What they call it, the COVID-15 or COVID-10 or whatever, mine was more like a COVID-47, you know, weight that I gained. I've been eating real bad, getting a lot of gas, real bad gas. I was at the grocery store the other day, and I went into their bathroom, and I was washing my hands, and I had really bad gas, right? And so your bathroom, it's okay. Nobody was in there, so I looked around, and so I let one rip. Oh, felt so good, but it was so loud. It was so loud that the toilet flushed on its own. I assume it's all said, you know, with something that loud, there's got to be some shit in here somewhere. So it just flushed. I was shocked. It was kind of funny. That's a true story. It's actually not actually a joke. And I figured I would share that with you guys because that's just like the weirdest thing. But I tell you, sometimes it's gas when I get because I've been eating bad. And I think I'm lactose intolerant. But I love ice cream and cheese and milk and butter and shit like that. So sometimes I do get bad gas and I go outside so nobody hears me because it's so loud. And I was outside one time early in the morning, just letting it go. Ah, felt good. Let it go. And then I came inside. And my daughter was standing right inside the door and it almost startled me when I walked in. I walked in, I was like, oh shit, what are you? She said, Daddy, you sound like you was outside arguing with somebody. I was like, no, that wasn't arguing. That was just me and my ass out there talking shit. That's all. Another true story. Flatulent stories, right? That's where we are now. You know, actually, I did this show for Steve. You know, this is like I said in the middle of the day. And actually, I was supposed to be shooting an HBO special today. But I said, no, fuck that. I'm going to do the hen house. Fuck HBO. I'm going to do my buddy Steve show. So here I am. Hopefully, you guys appreciate it. Yeah, man. I like to come over there. My boss, I got a new boss. Actually, he's from the UK. He is from the UK. So I'm still trying to figure him out. You know, we Americans, we tend to do everything loud and big and whatever, right? So one of the other things, we think everything, we force everything. So when we talk to somebody generally with a foreign accent, I don't know if you guys do this in your country, but if they have a foreign accent, we tend to scream at them thinking that the louder we speak, the more they'll understand it. So I don't know if over in the UK, if you guys do that like that or not, but over here we do that a lot. And I end up screaming at my boss sometimes. This guy's kind of an asshole. I hope he's not watching. I don't invite him to shows because I might very well talk about him. But maybe send him back to you guys. You know, and we'll keep Prince Harry and Meghan, and you guys can have him back. Yeah, so my wife, she started eating different. She's eating vegan now. Right. So now she thinks she's better than me. You know, she's always eating these nuts and berries and hummus, whatever that shit is. I don't know. Looks like it should be in a baby's diaper instead of a fucking plate. But she's eating that shit, man. And they're talking. They talk a lot of shit about what I eat. Because, like I said, I told you I get a lot of bad gas. But one day, the other day, I did have a wake-up call. Scared the hell out of me. They did. I had been eating so much processed food that when I went to take a shit, it came out in a can. Now, I can tell you right now, if you ever have a can come out your ass, it's a pretty good indication that you're not living right. So, changed my diet. I started eating all these whole foods and stuff. And I did have a fallback the other day. And you can see what happened when I ate that ice cream. I was in the fucking Home Depot place and farting and setting off fucking toilets all over the fucking store. Yeah. But I'm eating better now. I'm going to start eating better for sure. Right. So now when I go, if I start eating those whole foods and those eating all this organic stuff. So now when you go, you don't have to go to the rest. You can go right out in your backyard, right in your garden. Right. They call that compost. You know, and I tell you, your roses and petunias will never look better. And I can't wait for it when I start doing it, when the things start growing. I promise everyone that's listening by the sound of my voice, if you just hit me up at the end of the show, I'll put you on the list and I'll send you some fruits and vegetables from my garden. And you can have as many as you want. Just let me know. All right. I'll do that for you. Right from L.A. Organic, too. That's right. I found my son's weed. I found my son's marijuana. I found his stash. Right? And I did what any good parent would do. I smoked that shit. And man, did I regret it. Oh, Lord. I don't know what that shit is they smoke now. These kids. But before now, you know, when I was young, you smoked weed, man. You went like, all you wanted to do was laugh and, you know, eat. Had the munchies and, you know, eat with your friends. That's all you did was laugh and have fun. Now that shit's so strong, make you want to kill yourself. You know, had me rethinking my whole life and shit, thinking all the mistakes I made. You know, I got so high, thought I was having a conversation with Martin Luther King. And he was high too. You know, like, not for me. That shit's too strong. Too strong. I don't know what's going to happen with these kids today. Everything's so easy for them. You know, they got pornography on their cell phones. You know, if you want, it's. I had to stop. I mean, porn was disruptive in my life. You know, because you start jacking off, and I like to do it too much, man. Mm-mm. Bad for me. I used to love wanking off. I guess that's what you got. I don't know what you call it in the UK, but we call it jacking off. It's masturbating. And I used to do it so much. And I liked it so much that when I would have sex with a woman, I would fantasize about me jacking off. That's real. So now he's on his phone. You got on the phone. When we used to have to go to movie theaters. I mean, actual theaters. Like you go see Revenge of the whatever, the Jedi, or I know I picked a movie from like the 80s or 70s or something, right? Whatever the latest movies. I had been in theater so long, I can't even remember some of the movies I used to go see. But back then, you didn't get pornography on the cell phone. You had to actually go to the theater. That's right. Buy tickets at the box office, and everybody would see you going in there, so you'd have to go in disguise. You'd be out there standing there at the marquee at the ticket window, standing right there on the sidewalk, and people could drive by and see you. Say, hey, I see you going in there. Yeah, so you had to go in disguise, man. And you go and buy your ticket at the box office, you go in there and see it in this regular theater, and, you know, everybody, no one wants to look at each other because everyone feels like, you know, you're some kind of degenerate. And you think that the floors in theaters are sticky now? Yeah, they were way stickier then. Yeah, they were so sticky, you walked through, your shoe come off. That's how sticky the floors were. And if it did come off, you left that shoe. You'd hop your ass all the way out to the theater to your car. Because you wasn't going to try it at that point. It's no sense in even trying to get it out. Because you might slip and fall in it or lose your other shoe. So you just figured it was a done deal, right? Yeah, that's how it was back then. And then I guess everything's too easy. You know, you got dick pics. People sending dick. What the hell is it with these dick pics? Guys, I hear this all the time, and I can't wrap my mind around it. I just don't get it. You know, I never thought to show someone my penis who wasn't expecting, or it wasn't in the right context. You know what I'm saying? You know, just say, hey, you know, here's a picture of my penis. I know we met today at the library or something, and I just thought you might want to take a look at this. No, man. That's what I'm saying. It's too easy. Back then, if I wanted to show a girl my penis, I'd have to go over her house, knock on the door, ask her parents. Hey, Mr. Fredrickson, is your daughter home? Something I need her to take a look at. That's what you were doing back then. Now you don't do it. So, you know, like I said, man, life is just way too easy. Way too easy. But I'm not complaining. I'm not complaining. It's just an observation. And I think struggle and disappointment and rejection sometimes gives you character. But, you know, now with these kind of apps, all you have to do is swipe this way, swipe that way, and, you know, getmydicksup.com. You know, that's all you have to do is go to, you know, a website like that. I guess they pair it up with iwantmydicksup.com with iwantasuckadick.com, and then those two people meet, and then there you go. Everybody's happy. Like-minded people. I guess it's more efficient. I guess that's the way of the world now, is efficiency. But I just still think they're too easy.
Anyway.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Well, hey, thank you very much, my name is Daryl K. Mac, and I go by K. Mac, which is actually my last name, and is a Polish Jewish name. And I'm sure by looking at me, you guys probably already knew that. So, I
got it there.
Hey, yeah, hey, sure, man, thank you.
Thanks. Sir. I tried to cut you in there. We're running to a bit of a tight schedule now.
Okay.
But that's cool. Hey, thanks so much for we'll see you again soon.
Thank you.
All right, K Mac, ladies and gentlemen. God bless him. I've even got one of these now. That's good. Right. As I said, Av can't be with us tonight, but weirdly, he's just popped up downstairs. Downstairs? He's just popped up. Why? Let's give him his introduction. I don't know what you're doing here, Av. Why are you here?
Where are you? Let's be having you!
Hey, Av! So, unfortunately, you can't be with us tonight because you said you were too tired because you were working.
Yeah, it's been a tough week, Steve. I had to go back to work.
They've opened up, haven't they? They've said that you had to go back because you were working at home, weren't you? So now you've got 5 days working away from home.
Well, I had to work 2 hours this week. It's killed me.
2 hours? Oh, come on. Shake a leg. I bet you've done more than that.
No, I was asleep most of the time, and then when they asked me to work, it killed me.
So, because last week you said, Steve, you did that you could do the show because you said you're going to have a busy week. So you could have done the show if you've only done 2 hours work, mate.
I fit a lot into 2 hours of work. What most people fit in a day, I can do in an hour. So I did the equivalent of 2 days work in 2 hours.
You can't get quicker than a quick fit fitter. I bet you're exhausted.
I'm tired.
But bless you, you're all newsed out. Isn't that right, Av?
No.
Thanks for popping in and putting us right, Av. I mean, if you haven't got the time to do this, you haven't got the time to do this. It's fine.
No, I was watching the show anyway.
I don't know. He said, I don't want to do the show, and now he keeps popping up. Go back and put your feet up, Av. You're not welcome. Of course you're welcome, but, you know, you asked for the night off. You're getting the night off. Right, we're going to go all the way to Ireland. Ireland? Ireland. In the stream. Right, and it's Kenny.
Hello.
That's a bit laid back. Hello.
Howdy, beauty.
How are you, Kenny? You all right?
Not bad. Yourself?
Oh, do you know what? I'm fine. I'm like a. I don't know what I'm like. I'm like a wine. Do you know one of those? I'm like a mature wine.
Okay.
I've no idea what it means.
It's better than being an immature wine, I reckon.
Oh, hey! I would be that wine. I would be that wine. That would. I would burp purposely in the bottle.
Champagne.
Yay!
Exactly what it is.
Whereabouts in Ireland are you?
Dublin.
Whereabouts in Ireland are you?
Dublin.
Do you get it?
Jesus.
Dublin. See, honestly.
I fell for that.
I can't believe I said it. That's the thing. Oh, that's cool.
But so what's the difference between I don't know and neither do I?
I've got no idea.
Neither do I. It's one of those dad jokes. I think my dad actually told me that one. That's an official dad joke.
Oh, do you know, people say to me that that's a dad, and these are jokes that I original jokes of mine, people say are dad jokes. What are you going to do?
Every joke's a dad joke, really, isn't it?
Well, there's got to be. Every joke's a dad joke unless it's told by your mum.
Yeah, but she heard it off her dad.
Yeah. Hey, right. I'm gonna, because we're running a bit late. I'm gonna just kick you straight in. Is that all right?
Yeah, cool.
Are you ready for this?
I am ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am so excited. All the way from the Emerald Isle. Kenny is not. See, I told you I'd do that. Right, that's the one. Kenny.
Hey, you all there? How's it going? I hope you're all keeping well. I'm not doing great myself. I've recently been diagnosed with IBS, you know? Ignorant bastard syndrome. It's running right through me. Jesus. You know, I've kind of always had a big mouth. You wouldn't believe the amount of sex I've talked myself out of over the years, you know? And I'm getting old now. I'm like an old millennial. But in my 20s, I used to wake up whistling, spring in my step and a twinkle in my eye. I don't know what happened. You know, I think all that optimism slowly turned to skepticism, one fast and furious movie at a time. Until all that's left behind these eyes now is shock face emojis. You know? And it's hard not to be shocked when they keep making those movies. You know, fill me 8 times, will you? You know, did you hear them make a mission? I bet it's possible. It's been possible over 6 times now. The only mission impossible seems to be not making that movie. You know? And it's hard not to be skeptical these days. You know, it's hard not to be skeptical when every dating profile boldly states, I love to travel. Passionate traveler. Travel junkie. You're thinking, really? Do you backpack around Asia for 3 months of the year, do you? Hmm? you float down the Mekong while learning the local lingo, or, like the rest of us, do you just like going on holiday? Yeah? Who doesn't like that? You know, I'm at the age now where parents are looking for grandkids, you know? So I thought, I might get a dog, bring it home, and we can all fucking pretend. So I said I'd look into it, you know, see what type of commitment there was. You know, because getting a dog is a lot of responsibility. So I did some research, and what I come back with is, on average, a dog lives 11 years. And that's not bad. No, it's about 4,000 days. So I ran some numbers, and by my calculations, that's about 4,000 little shits you would need to pick up. Ew! You know, hand pick as well. Disgusting. And you know, statistically, they can't all be solid, can they? Like right now, there's millions of people walking around this world swinging a little bag of shit around in their hand. And we're all acting like that isn't gross, you know? I worked it out, not because I'm obsessed with shit, because I'm thorough with my research. That's half a ton of little shits per dog, you know? And I say little shits, but obviously the bigger the dog, the bigger the fucking log, you know? I seen it the other day. This guy was walking his mobile turd production plant, and this thing squeezed out what I can only describe as a Subway poo, foot long. This thing was a foot long, two-hand, bag over your fucking back type thing. And that's the real commitment to getting a dog, isn't it? No? I think at every dog pound, they should have a room with half a ton of little shits in it. And before anyone leaves with a puppy, they at least have to bag a few turds, at least know what they're getting themselves in for, or at least they can handle it or not. I tell you, I made my first nah fuck it list recently. If you don't know what a nah fuck it list is, essentially it's a bucket list, but you've come to terms with the fact you're not going to do any of that shit on there. You've outgrown it. You can sit down, make a nice evening of it, maybe have a beer, wine, bit of a meal, get that old bucket list out and just start letting shit go. You know? Skydiving. It's like, oh, jumping out of a plane. That sounds dangerous. I just don't have much time for that. Nah, fuck it. You know? Learn a new language. It's like, barely doing English right these days. A new language. That's so much effort. Nah, fuck it. You know? And I reckon letting go of it is just as fulfilling as actually doing it. Because I did a bungee jump. Let me tell you what a waste of time that was. It was a bungee push, in my case. Next thing you know, I'm hurtling towards this cesspool, dunking in and out like some kind of human teabag. It's like, nah, fuck that. You know, not worth it. Now, today is Good Friday. It's hard to be religious these days, isn't it? I can't help but feel the asymptomatic are God's chosen people, and the rest of us are just virus food. All right, that's me. Thank you.
That's me, thank you. I'm done now.
I forgot my hat.
I that's good. I like I can hear myself. Is that you or me?
That's you.
All right, thank you very much. I like your log dog. That was good. Hey, thanks so much for doing this, Kenny. Are you
thanks for having me. It's been great.
Are you gonna come back and do it again?
I will indeed, yeah, no problem.
Nah, you got it wrong. You got to go, nah, fuck it.
Nah, fuck it.
There you go.
Yeah, fuck it.
Yeah, okay, that's the thing. Hey, Stephen Kewin's in the house. Say hit it, Hen. Right, you can actually say all right tone as well if you want, Kenny.
Sorry?
If you say all right tone, they have a drink every time someone says all right tone. Uncle Tone. Yeah, you don't have to do it. You can have a drink. There you go. I'll have a drink. All right, Tone. There you go.
Fair enough. When in Rome, drink less.
Oh, do you like football?
Yeah, I'm fond of it.
Yeah, there's a score. Blues 0, Swansea 0.
Oh.
It must be a boring game.
It's nothing to me.
It's,
yeah, it's fucking Blues.
It's, yeah. 11 minutes in shorts. Nah, it's not the same. If you can't get people coughing over you, there's no point going to a football match. Is what I would say.
That's fine.
Hey, thanks so much, Kenny.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Stay around for the caption competition if you want. It should be coming up very soon. We're still waiting for someone else to join us from America who still thinks he's coming on in about 8 hours' time. He's not here yet. He might not.
I'll tune in tomorrow for that one.
That's it. Thanks very much, Kenny! Oh, he was waving goodbye and saying everything. Av, fuck's sake, mate. You're meant to be having a day off. Av.
Where are you? Let's be having you!
Hey, they were all right, weren't they?
Yeah, pretty good. I liked them.
I should point out, for those of you who are watching and they don't know, Av usually comes on at this point during the show to talk about the news, but we're not going to do that, are we?
Well, we can mention there was a report out this week regarding racism within the country.
Can I just stop you there, Av? There's no constitutional racism in this country. You know.
Imperial?
I don't care how you measure it, mate. It's not in here. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking I'm an old white man who has no idea what I'm talking about. But if you look at the committee...
Yeah. No. I mean, quite a few conservatives are quite angry, weren't they? That it wasn't racist enough, this country.
I really feel uncomfortable talking about this because really and truthfully, most of the people that wrote the report, that did the report, that filled in the report, don't actually believe there is such a thing.
Well, I don't trust them. You know what they say? Don't trust these ethnic minorities.
I've never said that.
I heard some white people say that. Sorry.
You heard some white people say that.
as long as you don't bay me.
Sorry, pay you.
Bay me.
Bame.
It sounds like blame.
I know it's quite good, but but right, I believe that we don't want to say BAME anymore because it's not right.
I like it. It encompasses everyone, doesn't it? And I think they say it's lazy, don't they? But it's like shall we say, you know, so if someone's white British, they might say no, I'm white Irish or white Scottish. Right, and then if we start calling them, like put them under all in one under umbrella, right, and just call them whiteies.
Whiteies?
No, does that work?
No, I mean, I think it's funny, but you can't just put a whole diverse group of people and put them under one banner, can you? Whiteies. What? Hey, when I was younger, so much younger than today, there was a government scheme which gave you like £35 a week for 6 months to go and work for other people, and it was, I'm sure it was called the Whiteies Express scheme.
The Whiteies Express. Did they call it? Isn't tiny whiteies mean white friends?
No, I think that is why institutional racism started. All white men have small penises. Tiny whiteies, underpants, man, underpants. Tidy whiteies, I think they were. Tidy whiteies. I'm not sure. Hey, are we ready for another comedian? Yes, we are. And we're staying in the United Kingdom. It is Viney. Hello, Viney.
Hello. All right.
How are you? Yes, thanks very much.
I'm fine.
Cool. I think my internet might be having a wobble because I'm slowing down, but it's one of those things.
My internet might be having a wobble too. I hope it's gonna survive because it was a bit dodgy earlier.
Oh god.
Hopefully you can hear me.
That's it. Everyone's on the internet now, aren't they? So how's your lockdown going?
It's okay, yeah. Well, I go out to work, which is nice, so I can I have a bit of sanity and I can see other people, so yeah.
Oh,
it's good. Not too
that's
bad.
It. Do you want to talk about your work? Because I know some people do, some people don't.
I work with children. I work with reception class, 4 and 5 year olds, which is interesting, but it's also fun. So yeah.
No, it's a nice age, that is. I remember when I was 4 and 5. It's just I don't like them together now, really.
Yeah.
It makes me...
They're cute, but they don't really get sort of social distancing, and they do... I mean, they literally sneeze in my face sometimes.
Oh, yeah, no. I've had that. They'll come straight up to you and cough, right? I was doing a class once. A little boy picked his nose, got it out, and he came up and he handed it to me.
Yeah.
I said, I'm not taking that. I'm not taking that. I don't want to set a precedent. Then we all, yeah. No, it's great fun. So whereabouts are you in the country?
I'm in Southampton, on the south coast.
Southampton. We like Southampton. Because it's near the Isle of Wight.
It is. I'm not sure that's a reason to like it.
Don't say that. We love the Isle of Wight.
Well,
ride where you walk, cows you cannot milk, fresh water you cannot drink. Come on. I did a school project when I was 4 and 5.
Oh, that's lovely. Well, it's also near the very beautiful and picturesque New Forest, which is
maybe
more on the postcards for Southampton. Not that you get...
Will's watching. Will from last week's watching. He said this about reception. It is the best. It only goes downhill from there.
Yeah. Reception's the best.
Sorry, I cut you off about your New Forest there. I apologise.
Oh, no, I was just... It's the attractive bit. And I said it would be on the postcards from Southampton, but you wouldn't really get postcards from Southampton because it's not exactly a holiday destination.
Do you know, that's going to be the next blockbuster from Steven Spielberg. Postcards from Southampton.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
No, yeah, I don't think anyone's going... Hey, are you ready? Hey, the thing is, it doesn't look like our other American friend is going to join us because I still think their time difference. They're not sure what time it is. So, but we know it's Viney time. So are you ready, Viney?
I am indeed.
Excellent. First time in the Henn House. It's Viney.
Hello. So I think we can all agree that when we look back on 2020, it will forever be remembered as the year of COVID-19. But we shouldn't forget that other things happened last year, you know, like Trump got voted out of office. There were the Black Lives Matter protests sweeping the world. And the film Parasite was the first foreign language film to win the Best Picture Oscar. And it was in many ways that Parasite set the tone for my year. Now, back in the early days of lockdown, the time now nostalgically referred to as the Tiger King era, grown men were having fistfights for the last 4-pack of Andrex and everyone was getting TikTok. Now, I got the tick, not the tock. That's what happens when you get lost in the woods on your hours government-sanctioned exercise. And that little guy was sucking my blood for 2 whole days before I even noticed he was there. Just like the time I had that goth stalker. And then in September, when all the children were coming back to the school where I work, people were tweeting things like, oh, how do you expect schools to keep COVID under control? They can't even manage head lice. Well, I found out that the hard way. Didn't get COVID, got the head lice, which was really irritating because the only thing that should be living rent-free in my head is the Duke from Bridgerton. And then right at the end of the year, I contracted something that's now living inside one of my internal organs, using my blood, making me feel quite ill, growing bigger and bigger. Yeah, I'm pregnant, which was kind of a surprise, not in like an accident way, but it took us quite a long time. I mean, not the act itself, that was standard 20-minuter from finger to finish. And we know it kind of takes us about that long because it's the perfect time to order a takeaway, have a quickie, and then be dressed in time for the food to arrive. It is a bit of a risky game, though, because you really don't want your Deliveroo driver to come first. But basically, we were trying for a baby for a very long time. And I think part of the reason it took us a long time is because my menstrual cycle is like super irregular. So we could never sort of time it right. And some people think that the menstrual cycle and the lunar cycle are linked because they're about the same length. But not mine. Mine's like 30-day cycle, 45-day cycle, 239-day cycle. I think my body's like, fuck you, moon. Maybe we'll start acting like you when you let women on you. It's very old-fashioned, the moon. It's got a worse admissions policy for women than a Saudi motoring club. And I bet if the moon disappeared for 239 days, NASA would do a very comprehensive job of finding out what the hell had happened to it. But I never got any answers about my issues, despite several emails to NASA. And apparently, when women spend lots of time together, sometimes their cycles sync up. And I work with a lot of women. So whenever I thought one of them was on their period, I would try and hang out with them, spend lots of time with them, just desperately trying to get our reproductive systems to sync up with each other, just like we're a couple of wireless speakers trying to link up via Bluetooth or Bluefoof, if you will. But eventually it works. So I'm knocked up in lockdown. Now, something that's been really getting my goat recently is people referring to holidays in Britain as staycations. No. A staycation to me is when you have some time off work and just stay at home and have some nice day trips and probably lots of lovely naps and maybe start drinking at home on your own at 11 a.m. And you know what? The authority that is Wikipedia agrees with me, and I quote, "A staycation, a portmanteau of stay and vacation, is a period in which an individual or family stays home and participates in leisure activities within day trip distance of their home and does not require overnight accommodation. Going to Cornwall takes 6 hours from where I live. It is not a day trip. Secondly, we're British. We don't even use the word vacation. We go on holiday. Going to Bognor Regis is still a holiday, even if you live in the same country as Bognor Regis. A much better way to describe it would be a country of origin holiday. But if you sort of squish those words together to make it more snappy, you just kind of get cunt-a-day. So there could be issues there. Now, finally, I have been trying to bite my tongue on this subject because no one likes to know it all. And I don't know who needs to hear this apart from apparently everyone on Facebook. But if you want to compare two things, it's than. It's got an A in the middle. Okay. If you're talking about something that happened after something else, it's then with an E. Okay. So all you conspiracy theorists, if you say I'd rather eat dog shit then wear a mask, well, good. I'm glad you're covering up your dog shitty breath with a mask after eating it. And if you said you'd rather shag your own mum than me, that's not an insult. That's just a disappointing threesome, as far as I'm concerned. Thank you very much. I've been Viney, a.k.a. Catherine Vine. Good night.
Hey, well done, a.k.a. Catherine Viney. Viney!
Just so people know how to look me up.
You've just also, I'm slightly dyslexic. It's a long term thing, really. And your then and than has really helped me.
Yes. Well, I'm glad.
I know it's now. I just have to look at my mother, and I just don't put an A in it.
Yeah. No.
Is that right? Is that
no? Yeah. You do. So, oh God.
No, I do. Oh, don't. No. See what I mean?
If you want but to compare, it's A.
All right. Don't. Right. No, but that's helped me. I'll rerun that and then I shall know. Thank you very much. Oh, also, I'm a man and I don't like talking about periods. But. Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean, it is really in there.
When did you do? When did you
do? Not till September.
Oh, cool. Oh, early September.
Yes. Yeah.
Because my birthday's 31st of August. You've got to get him in after the 31st, haven't you? Got to get him in after the 31st.
Do you know what? My birthday's actually the 30th of August.
Oh.
Yeah. So I don't really mind. Well, now I don't mind having that birthday, but I guess it was a bit annoying when I was younger.
Yeah, I was the youngest person in the class. Well, me and Leslie Clifford. So, so anyway... Thanks so much. Hey, should we try? Wade is actually in the building, but I don't think his camera comes up. We're going to try and see if I can do the caption competition. So I'm going to have to share the screen and bring other people in, if that's all right with you.
Of course.
Let's bring Kenny in and K-Mac and Wade. Hey, K-Max here. I don't know if Wade is going to connect, but can you all hear me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Kenny's not. Kenny, you got to unmute your mic if you want to speak to me. Kenny, that's good. Has anyone got a caption for this?
I didn't see that excellent one.
I know. I saw you commenting on last week's.
Prettier Patel.
Sorry, say it again, Kenny.
Isn't that Prettier Patel?
Yes, yes, indeed. Can I make
that bigger? Really sexist.
Well, it is, but I suppose if you are mentioning, Petty Patel is there as well. I was going to say something about the duck working undercover for the government.
Yeah.
Hey. Any more for Wade? Can you hear me, Wade? Wade, I don't know if Wade is actually in the studio, but his camera's not working. But there you go. So let's see what the next caption competition is. Ah, anyone got anything with that? This will be the first time Viney's seen it as well, bless her.
Yeah. Well, that could be my new maternity bra. Hopefully, I need some more.
Oh, bless you. Hopefully. I was going to say Kate and William open new brasserie. Right, I'm waiting for the laughter. Nobody? Okay. I should have said brasserie. Kenny, your turn. K-Mac, anything?
I've got nothing.
Got nothing. Here's another one. Oh, look at that cabinet. Well, it's going very well, everybody.
Oh, I can't believe I commented on the last week's one. That's what the link sent me, I tell you.
Yeah, I was thinking that when I saw them pop up on my phone. Right, I'm gonna stop the share screening and we're going to say goodbye because, oh, I'm not going to say goodbye because Wade's gone. He might come back, but I did think...
At the bookie for another show, I guess.
That's the thing. But you can stay if you want to, or you can go, because I'm going to go over and see Av and see what he's... Because he's still watching. Av, what's going on?
Where are you? Let's be having you!
You might need to... You might only be able to implement a thoroughgoing vaccination passport scheme, even if you wanted such a thing, in the context of you know, when absolutely everybody had been offered... a vaccine. So
he doesn't have to express and, you know, talk in a proper manner, which everyone understands, does he? Happy Monday. Happy Monday.
He said that, didn't he? He said that.
And
why did he say Happy Monday?
I know, because he wants everyone to act like the Happy Monday, smoke crack, dance like Bez. Yeah, and he was twisting my melon, man.
Thanks, Av. Hey, Av's gone again. Hey, look, Wade's back. Everyone say hello to Wade.
Jesus. He looks like a turning circle.
Still can't find his way.
Boris
Johnson's hair. Why is his hair like that?
Apparently, he does it on purpose.
Guys, he reminds me of a older, frumpled Boris Becker.
Yes, the tennis player.
Yeah, he looks just like Boris Becker, but old. Or he kind of looks like the actor Gary Busey.
Oh, can I say Mad Gary Busey anymore? I don't suppose I can, but I do like Gary Busey. Do you know what? I suspected we would have, because I didn't do a sound or video check with Wade, bless him. So I'm going to say I have a backup plan, people. Now you can stay and watch my backup plan or you can go, but thanks so much for being in the hen house. We've got four and a half minutes of Dom Mackey from last year. Is that all right? Because Wade, I don't think your cameras were. He's gone again. Right. Thank you so much, Kenny. Thank you so much, Viney. Thank you so much, K-Mac. You've been in the hen house. We're going to finish with... I'm going to give him one more chance. He's back, Wade. Come on, Wade. You can do it, Wade.
Wade.
Oh, bye. Right. We're going to go to another person. We're going to go to Dom. Dom's come in to say he's going to come and help us out because he's our surprise guest. Let's say hello to Dom. Dom. Oh, I don't like that. I like it like that. What are you doing, Dom?
Hello. Hello. You all right?
Hello. Have you got echoes? I'm okay. I thought you had echoes.
No, it's just my weird thing going crazy. How you doing?
I'm all right. I think the last time I saw you, you didn't have a big beard, did you?
No, this is what lockdown's done to me and not leaving the house and being rejected by loads of people. I thought, you know what, no one to impress, so sod it.
Yeah, well, thank you so much for jumping in at the last minute. You're going to come back in a couple of weeks, though, aren't you? You're just doing this
I am indeed. This is basically, I thought I'd try some new stuff. If people like it, then I'll do it once the lockdown's over. If people don't worry.
You won't do it.
Never going to be played again.
Yeah, but you see, that's the thing. But you have to do it again, though, because sometimes I do stuff, nobody laughs, right? I do it again, nobody laughs. But I still think it's funny myself.
See, that's the thing. Everyone has a different sense of humour. What you're basically saying, Steve, is people don't laugh at you. They're wrong.
Yeah.
Simple as.
It is. It's the only way to run a country. Right. I'm going to let you get on with your bit. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, give him a big round of applaudage. It's Dom Mackey.
Hello, guys. I've nearly finished my pint because it's Friday and I don't really care, to be honest. I'm having another one after this. Don't you worry. I'm more to get through this night. I'll tell you that. I'll tell you the truth. I'm in the mood for celebrating. So if you've got alcohol on you, raise your glass right now. Raise your glass because I have finished my job. I finished my job. I'm so excited to finish my job because I'm moving on to another job. See, that's the good thing about the summer. You move from one job to another and you get a tan at the same time. It's every plus. I'm actually starting my new job later on in September to be a teacher. And obviously, I remember my rites of passages when I was at school. For example, the first experience with porn. That's always a unique moment. Everyone has that first experience with porn. It either happens when you find a bag in someone's forest, or you go under your bed and your dad's bed and you find his porn, or you accidentally play Two Girls, One Cup by mistake. Everyone has that first experience of porn. I'm going to share with you mine because I've got beer and alcohol and I don't care. So my first experience, okay, I was in year 8, which, as you can tell by the beard, was quite a long time ago. And I remember I went to my friend's house and he was showing me a game called Bus Simulator. That's genuinely what the game's called. His parents must have thought, oh, wow, our kid's going to grow up to be normal. No, he wanted to know what it was like to drive the 213 to Kingston. That's what he wanted to feel like. So he got this game and he was showing me Bus Simulator. Literally, you drive a bus and you pick people up. How weird is that game? So I was watching him play it because obviously I can't play it. It's way too hardcore for me. And I thought, you know what? I'm in the mood for a drink. Not alcoholic, because, you know, year 8. Come on, guys, keep up. So I went downstairs for a glass of water. Now, every time you go to a friend's house, you always have that awkward conversation with the mother. She's always downstairs and you always bump to her and you can't just ignore her. You can't just go past and just not say anything. You always have to say like, thanks for having me, that kind of thing. And you're always, and she's always making this sort of chicken nugget, fish finger, smiley potato waffles dinner. That's what she's always doing when you go downstairs. So I say, oh, thanks for having me. And then she gets into a 20-minute conversation about how her son wants to be a famous photographer. I didn't break the news to her that he wants to be a 265 bus driver. But you know what? I listened to her waffle. Then I realised it was that was 25 minutes later. She basically went over on a bit of a tangent. So I was like, okay, I've actually got to go up to my friend because that's the reason why I'm there. So I went upstairs back to my friend's house, hoping to see the lovely experiences of the bus stop. But it turns out that he was actually watching porn and masturbating. That's what I walked into. It was quite an interesting sight. I completely froze. I was expecting to see two old people get on a bus, not two old people get on each other. I was completely frozen on the spot. I didn't know what to say. I was stuck for 20 seconds. So I decided I couldn't think of what to say. So I just paused and I went, so I'm going to go now. And this was a genuine response. This is genuinely what he said to that. Hold on. I'm nearly done. I don't care if you're nearly done. That's not what I want to hear. That's so awful. I ran outside the house. I ran to the bus stop. I didn't jump on the bus stop because I started getting flashbacks and my sweating started to kick in. So I ran home and I never told anyone this story until I had this drink. So you're welcome. But I have to admit, even though I'm kind of celebrating finishing the job, it has been quite sad. Because when I left the job today, I worked at school just beforehand. One of the kids actually came up today and they were really upset that I was leaving. They actually said to me, please don't go. So I thought, well, I have to. I've got my new job. And this is genuinely what they said. They then said, will I never see you again? And this is really sad because they were kids who I'd worked with a lot. And they're such a fun person to hang out, like to work with. They were a lot of laughs. So I said to them, don't you worry. I'll probably come back and visit. You will see me again. And I shit you not, this is genuinely what their response to that was. Fantastic. But when you come back, lose the beard. Thank you so much, guys. I've been Dom Mackey, and I'll go back to you, Steve. Cheers.
Thanks, Dom. Stepping in at the last minute there in the hen house before and again tonight. Wade, bless you. Your connection isn't working. Thank you, everybody, for being in the hen house tonight. We had K-Mac, we had Viney, we tried to have Wayne, and we had Kenny, K-Mac, Viney were here, and we had Av Singh. Av, anything you want to say before we go?
Where are you? Let's be having you!
Ah, Av's back. What do you think of that one, then?
Yeah, that was pretty good, wasn't it?
It was all right. I don't know where he's coming from. Anyway, talk to me about your underpants.
On the 8th of March, 29th of March, then the 12th of April, the 6th of May, and the 17th of May. We'll begin no earlier than the 21st of June.
So, you've been working this week.
I don't know. I'm more over. Can you be any clearer? I don't know.
I have no idea, because I know that this last week when you started work, so that's why you're not here tonight, is because things were opening up. But then we got another week, and then they open up a bit more, don't they? All the shops. Well, just older shop.
Yeah. Well, I'll get confused with it. I've seen people getting rid. Like, I think on the news, I saw everyone. Was it Cannon Hill Park went mental? It was like an exhibition boxing match.
Can I just stop you there? I don't think you can say the word mental anymore.
No. It went berserk?
I think you could say berserk. As long as you... I think you can say COVIDiots.
There was a bunch of COVID... A bunch. There's loads of them. I was watching the news. Somehow, there was an exhibition boxing match with boxing gloves.
What, in the park?
In the park, right? And then there was clubbing, and there was fighting.
What, like dancing or
dancing?
Seal?
Yeah, dancing. There was dancing. I wouldn't be surprised if there was.
Seals.
Yeah, Cannonail Park. Yeah.
I can't see the porpoise in them myself.
Yeah, sure.
It is. I mean, I can understand. I can understand people. People are thinking that everything's better now because we've got the vaccine. I'm all right, by the way. And people, you know, have stayed in a lot longer, and we're bringing the R rate down and stuff like that. But as Matt Hancock says, I ain't got a clue what I'm doing.
You don't need to say it. You can look at him. You can tell he doesn't know what he's doing.
It's like the lights on, but no one's home. It isn't. I never knew what that expression meant until I looked into his face. Thanks, Av. Oh, my goodness. We've come to the end of the show. Wade is still trying his best to be part of the show. He says he's here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to say goodbye. Thanks, Viney. Thanks, K-Mac. Thanks, Kenny. Thanks, Wade, for trying. Thanks, Av. And thanks, Dom, for stepping in at the last minute. We'll be back next week. Have a lovely Easter weekend. I'm going to say goodbye, and then I'm going to hand you over to Wade for the rest of the evening. So thank you so much, everyone. Have a lovely weekend. Bye-bye.
Fuck you. Goodbye, you hurt me for the last time. It's time for me to move on. So fuck you and goodbye. I gave you love and I hate it. Yeah, all of the time that I wasted. Fuck you, goodbye. You hurt me for the last time.